मिस्टर राजेश कुमार, लर्नेड काउंसिल फॉर द एपिलांट्स हैज़ ड्रॉन आवर अटेंशन टू द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस ऑफ द अपॉइंटमेंट विद रिगार्ड टू द सर्विस कंडीशंस ऑफ द रेस्पोंडेंट एंड आल्सो टू द कम्युनिकेशंस बिटवीन द एपिलांट नंबर वन एंड द रेस्पोंडेंट. Learned counsel for the appellants submitted before us that the High Court was wrong and incorrect in holding that the order terminating the services of the respondent was stigmatic. It was also submitted that it cannot be said that the appellant number one was biased against the respondent in taking the decision to terminate his services as the Board of Directors was responsible for passing a resolution to the effect of termination of the services of the respondent after considering the entire records and performance and assessment report of the respondent. Ms. Sarita Dwivedi, learned senior advocate appearing for the respondent, on the other hand, submitted that a bare perusal of the order of termination dated 29/11/1999 would indicate that the same was stigmatic and therefore the High Court was justified in setting aside the same, as the same was issued without giving any opportunity to the respondent and without conducting any inquiry in that regard. It was also submitted that the decision of the Board of Directors to terminate the services of the respondent was the result of bias of appellant number one and also influenced by him, as he was very much present in the meeting of the Board of Directors in which the decision to terminate the services of the respondent was taken. In the light of above submissions made by the counsel appearing for the parties, we have perused the entire records. The respondent was appointed as executive director wide letter dated 3/6/1998 on specific terms and conditions, one of which was that he would be on probation in the aforesaid post for a period of 1 year from the date of joining the post. It was also stated in para 3 of the letter of the date appointment that if the aforesaid terms and conditions are applicable / acceptable to the respondent, he may indicate the date of joining within 10 days. The respondent accepted the aforesaid offer of appointment along with terms and conditions appended thereto and also specifically accepted the position that he would be guided by the rules and regulations applicable to the appellant number two. We have already extracted the rule position governing the service conditions of the respondent. The respondent was ordered to be on probation for a period of 1 year and as per clause 3.2 of service rules, his performance during the period of probation was to be reviewed by the company and that the company could extend the period of probation or termination the service of the respondent at any time or at the time of probation period. On the other hand, clause 3.3 of service rules stated there has to be an order communicating the order of confirmation to the officers concerned after the end of the period of probation.